Hello everyone, my name is Cristian Negulescu and you know me for a lot of automation with UiPath. I have the connector for Salesforce, ServiceNow, Jira, Confluence and so on. Here on the videos that I create a lot of videos in the last time that allow you to start a robot from ServiceNow, Salesforce, from NetSuite, from JSON, from Power Automate, from Grovy and so on. So you send some comments to the orchestrator. In our case, all the demonstration have been done with the UiPath Cloud platform. And I'd create also a video how to send this message from Postman on the on orchestrator that it's on-prem. Today, we will do a start of the process from Google Go. Yeah, so if your developers use Google Go, let's see how you start a new UiPath robot from Google Go. Yeah, as usual, I will put all the code on the here on the GitHub. Yeah, you have the code for Power Automate, for Salesforce, ServiceNow, and so on, all the things that I create. Good. So let's see what we have. I already have the code here, and I will explain a little what I did. As usual, we have the two processes with MSG simple and MSG param, where we have also parameters. So, what I do? You have to import bytes. You have to import JSON to be able. You have to import HTTP. Some libraries to be able to work with this. Then you have. I define here a structure for the response of the authentication from where we need to read the access token. And let's see what we have. We send the data as usual with a grant type, client ID, refresh token, and so on. We format it in a JSON and we send it to account@uipa.com token. And after we put the headers, we will receive a response. If the response doesn't have an error, then we'll convert this JSON, and from this JSON we'll print the access token. With the access token, we will start a process. Yeah, first we'll start with a simple process to be able to start the process. Let's put the J back. Okay, to be able to start the process, I will create a JSON with these parameters. It's the release key of the process. You have on the other video on the with the Postman on the first video from the Postman exactly how you extract the release key of the process, and then we'll send a command to the orchestrator in cloud to start this process with our parameters. Yeah. Then we put all the headers, including the authorization, and then we'll get the response. So I have this. Let's save it. Normally Go, it's for a lot of systems. I just put it on my Windows to show you the idea and share the code, and then you can use it from mobile phone and other stuff to start the robot and see the results from the robot. So now I start the simple process, and you can see here that the simple process was started a few seconds ago. And if I go to the logs and we'll refresh, we'll see that we'll have a log from the hello start from orchestrator. Yeah, let's start also the complex process. So we'll modify and we'll have the process with parameters. So here I have the process with parameters. Here you can see that I send param one test YouTube Go. Okay, and put them here Go language 2103. Yeah, so let's see it save. And then I will go and say run this code. So the system will take the access token, and then normally we have to get the response from the orchestrator that this command was done. Yeah, and we'll see on the orchestrator the response. So we have everything. We have the response back. And we'll check on the orchestrator to see if, look. So this was created successfully a few seconds ago. Let's see it. And you have here hello from test YouTube Go and hello log with 2103. So in this way, I'm able to start an UiPath orchestrator process on the UiPath orchestrator from Go. As usual, I will put the code here on the GitHub. Also, if you want to do this on-prem, check out my movie on Postman, how you do it on the Orchestrator prompt. There are a little difference on the commands. And remember to follow me on the YouTube for other videos and ask me what else you want to see on in the integration with UiPath. Thank you very much for watching. Stay safe. Have a good one. Bye.